Dear students, welcome to YouTube channel of our Sangli Shikshan Sanstha. Today we are going to learn Standard 8 SST History Lesson Number 1 Sources of History. Here we have our 8th Standard History and Civics textbook. Let us look at the preface of Standard 8 textbook. The structure of the textbook is designed with the objective that the subject should be properly understood, felt interesting and get inspired by the work done by our great ancestors. By studying this textbook, we hope that along with knowledge, your learning will also become meaningful. For this purpose, colored pictures, maps are given in the textbook. Every chapter of the textbook should be studied attentively. Those parts which are difficult to understand can be explained by your teachers and parents. The content given in the table will increase your curiosity. If you want to know more, then through the medium of app using the QR code, useful audio visual material related to the chapter will be available to you. It will be definitely be useful for you. Study. An attempt is made to make history interesting and will surely develop within you a liking for the subject. The history part deals with modern India history. The textbook is written by combining new trends in history and core values of national education. By studying the textbook, it will be clear as how to know the principles of liberty, equality and fraternity and justice evolve in the history of modern India. There is an introduction to sources of history of modern India in the textbook. Similarly, an overview of the expansion of British rule in India is taken. Information about the unforgettable fight given by the Indian people to free India from the chains of British rule is given in the part of history. The concept of source. Source is where someone or something comes from. The point of origin of a stream or a river. Someone or something that supplies information, a reference source. A cause or starting point of source of rumors, that is gossip. Sources of history. Historical source means historical data is original source that contains important historical information. These sources are something that inform us about history at the most basic level, and these sources use as clues in order to study history. History in its broadest sense is everything that ever happened. It includes documents, artifacts, archaeological sites, features, oral transmissions, stone inscriptions, coins, paintings, images and oral history, etc. Some inscriptions help us to understand our history. Sources of ancient Indian history are material sources, written sources and oral sources. Material sources includes artifacts and structural remains, which involves rock paintings, beads, ornaments, caves, temples, etc. Written sources includes inscriptions on Harappan seals, Vedic literature, travelogues, books on grammar, etc. Oral sources, ovis, folk songs, folk tales, etc. Through these sources, we learned about ancient Indian history. Material sources comprise of different objects, places and their ruins, that is remains. Let us learn about the points from the lesson. Material source, buildings and places, statues and memorials. Written sources, newspapers and periodicals, maps and drawings. Oral sources, inspirational songs, povadas, etc. Video, audio and audio visual sources, photographs, recordings, films, etc. Sources of modern Indian history. Sources of modern Indian history are material sources, written sources, oral sources and audio-visual sources, which provides insights about the period to which they belong. The material sources tells us about the religious beliefs of the people in that period, like temples, clothes, articles, toys, etc. Also, we can find new ideas about things, know about different research, etc. with the help of these sources. All these sources contain important historical information. Data available in the past was not uniform in systematic or organized manner. They are clues to examine historical events in detail. Therefore, to assess the reliability of the details, all above mentioned sources of history are gathered and thoroughly checked. Dear children, let's understand above points in detail. Material sources. It includes various objects, places, coins, sculptures, etc. Buildings and monuments. The period of British rule and period of governance of princely states is known as the period of modern Indian history. Various buildings, bridges, roads and water supply system, fountains, etc. were built during this period. Government offices, residence of officers, leaders and revolutionaries, palaces, forts, prisons, etc. were built during this period. Some of these monuments are declared as national monument while some are converted into museums. A monument is a type of structure that was explicitly created to commemorate event or a person. We get to know about contemporary history, architecture, nature of the monument and also the economic condition of that particular period by visiting these sites. The statues are also important for the study of modern history, as we get information about the full name of the concerned person, detail about their contribution and a biographic sketch of that person from the plaque. A plaque is a flat piece of stone where name is written, that is fixed on a wall, displayed on it. The statues also provide information about the contemporary rulers and eminent famous personalities. Memorials erected in memory of various events give information about the related event, people, period related to the event. Example, Hutatma Smarak. Museum and history. For the study of history, various objects, paintings, photographs and such other things are preserved in a museum at the Aga Khan Palace in Pune. We can see different objects, documents given information about the life of Mahatma Gandhi. Written sources. Written sources includes correspondence, periodicals, foreign accounts, factory records, newspapers, autobiographies, biographies and books. Now let's learn in detail about written sources of modern history. Newspaper and periodicals. Information we get from newspaper is on a contemporary events, detailed analysis of particular event, views of eminent people, opinions published in editorials, political, cultural, social and economic happenings of that period. Newspapers in the pre-independence period. Jnanoday, Jnan Prakash, Prabhakar, Amrit Bazar Patrika, Din Bandhu, Kesari. All these newspapers contributed in the pre-independence period about social awakening and education of the masses. Here masses means common people wanted to know what happened in the surrounding areas where they live. The politics of the British government and their effect on India can be studied. Sources of social reformation. In the weekly Prabhakar, Nibandha Mala by Vishnu Shastri, Chiplunkar and Shatapatre by Lokhitwadi were published. They commented on various social and cultural issues. Maps and drawings. The British government surveyed various provinces and cities of India through scientific method and created maps. The Survey of India was independent department formed for the purpose during British period. we get an idea about changing phases of development of a city or place through maps. Plans designed by architects and engineers are important as it throws light on progress in architecture. The original map of Bombay Port is with Department of Mumbai Port Trust. Through this, we get information about the development of Bombay City through plans. Oral sources. Introduction. The oral sources are compositions that are passed on from one generation to the other by way of information and thus preserved. Oral sources includes inspirational songs, folk songs, povada, folk tales, narrations, interviews, fairs, jalsas, art groups, rhythmic prose, ovi. Just we have seen about oral sources. Oral literature was written down in later period. Inspirational songs. Though many inspirational songs were composed during the freedom movement, only some are available at present. A lot of songs were memorized and never got published. We get information about the conditions during pre-independence period. They gave inspiration to the society, infused spirit in the freedom movement. Povada. Povada is a dramatic narration by alternatingly reciting poetry and prose extract one by one afterwards. It is a source to get information about historical work of a person or event. They were composed on freedom struggle of 1857 and valor of revolutionaries during the British rule are presented through povadas. Satyashodhak Samaj composed povadas to awaken the oppressed classes. During the Sanyukta Maharashtra movement also povadas were composed. Sanyukta Maharashtra movement means it was an organization in India that advocated for a separate Marathi-speaking state in Western India and Central India from 1956 to 1960. They infuse enthusiasm and vitality, means they make energetic to the people. Audio-visual sources. Visual source photographs. After the development in the art of photography, it became important source of modern Indian history. Medieval period paintings are available which depicts physical features of a person or visual description of a particular event. But the authenticity of such paintings are to be verified. Photographs are considered more reliable as the lens capture the persons, events, objects exactly as they appear. The photograph of a person gives information about physical features, dressing styles, etc. Photographs enable us to create visual image of an event. The photograph of an object or structure helps in understanding its nature. Next, we'll go further with audio source recordings. In the modern period, speeches of leaders or important personalities, songs, music are available in the form of recordings. Recordings of Janagana Mana sung by Rabindranath Tagore himself, speeches of Subhash Chandra Bose and lectures of leaders and thinkers are available. They can be used as a source of history as they give information on prevalent. Prevalent means particular place at particular time, social and political conditions and ideologies. Audio-visual sources, films. Films, movies and documentaries are audio-visual sources of modern Indian history. Dadasaheb Phalke laid the foundation of Indian film history in the year 1913. Audio-visual recordings at Dandi Yatra, Salt Satyagraha, Quit Movement are available. The advantage of the technological development in that is that the events could be seen in reality. Documents are short on superstitions, which was important in process of rebuilding the nation. We come to know about prevalent conditions, problems, dressing style through audio-visual sources. Now one important thing is to we have to preserve these sources. So how to preserve these sources we will see in detail. Preservation of sources. Museums, archives, that is collection of historical documents, preserve the sources of history. These sources give evidence of our rich cultural heritage. While referring the written sources, the ideology and the opinion of the author regarding the political event should be examined. In short, today we have studied all three sources and their examples. With this study, we come to know about what has happened in the past. Also, nowadays, we use social media like Google, YouTube, etc. to know about the events that took place in history before 1 year, 2 years, or 5 years. Thank you. Please like, share, and subscribe our YouTube channel.